Have you ever wondered where your robot can live? Providing a home for your robot is very important, especially if it's supposed to do automated tasks and run by itself. So it is not always the best solution to have your robot run on top of your computer. Why? Because you might be doing certain things on top of your computer, therefore it might be an interference with you and your robot working at the same time. So what is a good solution if you don't want to install the robot on your computer? So if you don't want to install Power Automate Desktop on your computer, what you can do is set up a virtual machine. Now this is completely up to you and entirely up to you. You can continue learning Power Automate Desktop and Flow without absolutely no virtual machines. However, if you would like to have maybe 10 robots doing different things, you would like to set up 10 virtual machines. It will be much cheaper than buying 10 different computers. So in this short video, I will show you how to set up a virtual machine that you require for Microsoft Power Automate Desktop. Now, setting up a virtual machine, I will be doing it from Microsoft Azure. Once we have logged into Azure, I will go to virtual machines. I can also simply search for it and I will create a new virtual machine. There is just some basic configuration that we have to set up. We have to create a new resource group if we haven't done one already. And we also have to select the type of virtual machine that we wanna set up. Now, the only virtual machine or the only operating system supported by Power Automate Desktop is Windows 10 Pro. So let's select that. And that is going to be the virtual machine that we are going to set up. We are also going to set up a username and account for our machine. So we will call this. All right, after that, we can basically set up our instance. Let's make sure that we set a spot instance so that the price is going to be lower for our machine. We can leave all of the other configuration as we want. Let's just set up a name for our virtual machine and let's call it RPA Champion, and we'll call it 1. Obviously, we cannot contain underspaces, and our virtual machine is ready to go. Now, all options have been configured. Now, let's select the disk size. So, let's select a standard SSD, standard encryption, and let's attach an existing disk. So let's go on to networking. We can leave all of the settings as they are. We are going to enable auto shutdown of our machines at 7 p.m. in case we do not do it ourselves. And let's configure advanced configuration. We do not need anything in the advanced configuration. We can choose to add some tags. We can review and create our virtual machine. Now, this is how much our virtual machine is going to cost. It is going to cost around $0.0390 per hour. Now, once this is configured, we are going to be able to launch the creation process that is going to create our virtual machine. So all of the validation part have been passed correctly and we can create our virtual machine. Now to create the virtual machine, all I have to do is click on create and this will create ourselves the virtual machine. Now, what is cool about this, that if there is anything about this that I do not like or about this virtual machine that I am not satisfied with, I can cancel it and delete it without any costs or charges. So I will be only charged if I use my virtual machine and if I log into it and I have performed different actions. Otherwise, the virtual machine will not charge me or cost me anything. Right now, the virtual machine is being deployed. Once it's deployed, I will receive instructions on how to log in, and I will be able to log in and use this virtual machine. Once the virtual machine has finished the deployment process, we can go to the resource and access our virtual machine. So let's see how we can do that. We will click on the go to resource. We would have all of the details that we require. Now I will be shutting down this machine after this experiment, so there is no need to copy any of the information that I'm sharing right here. On the left side, we have all of the different information regarding our virtual machine, but all we have to do is click on connect, select RDP, that is going to be the way that I will be connecting. Select on RDP, and after that I can download the RDP file. Now once the RDP file is downloaded, I can just click on the RDP file and this will be presented for me. Now once I click on connect, I will be have the ability to insert the credentials that I have created previously. So RPA champion and the password that I have used. Once the password is accepted and everything works, we can log inside of our virtual machine. So we are logging in inside of our virtual machine. So guess what we are going to do inside of this virtual machine? We are going to set up Microsoft Power Automate Flow, desktop, the gateway, so that we can have another robot that is ready for us to utilize and to work with. Once the virtual machine has finished all of the configuration, we can see it right here. So the first thing that I will be doing, a couple of things on this machine to make it ready for me to use. I will be installing a couple of plugins that are going to make browsing faster and smoother. I will be installing Microsoft Google Chrome. So I will also be installing an ad block functionality for Google Chrome to prevent, to make pages load faster and just be more reliable overall. So obviously the first thing that we're gonna download is Microsoft Power Automate Flow and desktop. And we have seen how to do those previously. So there it is, ladies and gentlemen. This is how we would create a new home for our robot instead if we didn't want to run it on our computer and on our machine.